Hello, this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Quest IV! Let's finish the Fungeon. Finish going through the Fungeon here. Sorry, yesterday's episode was a little short before getting Mini Metal number 68. I was just a little tired yesterday, so I didn't want to go too far into it yesterday. But today we're going to go through to the end and through the boss, so I'll put a little extra length on today's episode to make up for it. Got a new a new episode, and new enemies in this episode. The jugular. Yeah, that's a very clever game. They're juggling, eyeballs or something? I don't know. But they're pretty well susceptible to any element. No debuffs that I care about would work on them, but we can just kill them anyway. Just whip them to death. Holy cow. Give them whiplash. Whip flare? No, that's a good magic card. But here we get an Angel Leotard. Alright, so let's give that to Maya there. That'll give her breath and magic protection. It's really good. Might be my favorite piece of equipment in the game. It's gotta be up there. But anyway, I don't think there's any enemies on this floor. I could be wrong. Oh, well, there's a slime up there. No, but I don't know if you can meet up with random enemies on this floor. Oh, yeah, that was a while ago, but too late now. Nothing we can do about that. But, well, it's nice that we get a little more background on what happened there. I wonder what Sorrow's minions are doing here, though. I mean, I suppose there is that hole in the ground there. Maybe they were the ones who made it, I don't know. Why do they put these things everywhere? I'm gonna throw away those boxer shorts, because I don't even need those. Yeah, just transfer them out of my inventory. And then I'm gonna throw the horse manure into the boxer shorts that I threw out just now. President Delling, is that you? No, just a zombie. I don't know. I still don't get why they do that with their leak speak or whatever you call that. I don't know. There's another one? Huh. Well, I wonder if there's a way we could put that to use. Nah, I don't think so. Just wishful thinking. If only. Well, anyway. Reminds me of Cove's Cove. That's what I heard the name was of the cave southeast of Themyscira. But anyway, these guys, easy enough. Oh, I love Elena with the whip there. She can just annihilate these guys. They don't stand a chance. But here we get the final mini medal in the game. Mini medal number 69. Not that we're going to use them. But they're there. Here we got another new enemy. Seesaw. Yeah, Seesaw. Yeah, very funny game. Again, these guys have no debuffs that I care to use, but they are susceptible to almost any element except Whoosh, which doesn't matter for me. They do have some really powerful breath attacks. Not again! That's not working out at all like I had planned. At least Ragnar's doing something useful. Yeah, we gotta finish them off. Maybe get Sage Stone in, or not. Okay, I'm probably gonna have to heal up a little bit after that one. Trying to conserve Solo's MP, because this is the last time we're gonna be able to that last point there at the Pinnacle Chapel, that's the last healing point that we got until the end. So, I warped out, came back here, rested at an inn, and came back here off screen. But anyway, we got another new enemy, Periwinkle. I don't know. Probably a pun. I know that it's a color, but I don't know if that's a pun for something else. Let's see. Pretty much immune to almost any element, except, like, Zap. I could use Zap. I want to save my MP. Like, Zap, that'd be really good. And they are susceptible to Snooze, if I had that, but I don't. So, oh well. Yeah, debuffs, not so useful here. I mean, there's a few here and there, but, and particularly on old enemies, but as far as new enemies go, not so much. But that's okay. Wow, Why does this area look like something that would have been in Dragon Warrior 7? I don't know. I've never played that game before, or at least not very far into it. But, I don't know, it just kind of looks like something that would be in that game. Because people have been telling me that some of these maps that they got here resemble that in Dragon Warrior 7. Or some people were saying that was only in the PlayStation version of Dragon Quest 4, but then they changed it in the DS version to avoid spoiling it for some people. I don't know. I've never played it. So, I've never played the PlayStation version of this game, and I've never played the Dragon Warrior 7. Here we got another new enemy, Hijinx. Yeah, that's another pun. Let's see, same thing as the last guy, Sea Sword. Pretty much immune to debuffs, and they're immune, or they're susceptible to most elements except Oosh. So, they got a bit less HP, and not so much on the spells that I'm really worried about with them. One thing I was thinking about, I am looking into a Dragon Quest V Let's Play. I haven't announced it yet, but I'm thinking about it. And I was looking at the PS2 version of the game. I probably wouldn't LP that version. I'd probably LP the DS version. That was a Pandora's box there. But yeah, I was taking a look at the PS2 version. It's like, wow. I mean, look at how much effort they put into that. They even have an English translation patch for the game. So I might consider at least checking it out. It looks pretty cool. I saw some of the cutscenes. Holy cow. That is epic. But anyway, we got another new enemy, Togers! Ogre wearing a toga. Yeah. Let's see, they are susceptible to Frizzle. They're susceptible to Fizzle, which can prevent them from casting Oomph. They can also cast Zap, so you gotta watch out for that. But we have Fizzle. I probably could have equipped an item for that, but whatever. And they're susceptible to any elemental magic, so we're pretty well set there. Fortunately, they're not using oomph on each other, so we should be good. I love it when I can get my Sage's Stone to go off before Elena finishes off the enemies. That's why I was thinking of giving her the Sage's Stone originally, but, well, I changed my mind. I think it's better on Maya now. I only played this game like four or five times, so yeah, I don't know everything about the game. I do what I can with what I've got. But anyway, alright, we made it to the final part of the Fungeon. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rearrange my party as I've listed in the video description, and I'll be right back. Carver, is that you? What are they doing there, anyway? I don't know. Okay, we're all set and ready to go. But yeah, the guy on the right there does kind of look like Carver, I don't know. Kind of reminds me of Zell when he was graduating. But anyway. Fu Yang? Is that a kind of a Chinese food? I know chow mein is a Chinese food, but I don't know about Fu Yang. I'm not going to bother pointing out all the puns. I'm Cuckoo for Cuckoo Puffs! Nah. How's it going? Walk. Yeah. No. But thou must. Well, it's time to fight it out for the cream of Samyangat. For boss time! Nah. Just kidding. But okay, this is probably one of the hardest fights in the game. You gotta get sap on Fu Yang and insulate on everyone here. Hopefully I can get insulate up first. Come on. Yes! Okay, we're in good shape. Whew! That is with insulate and max breath protection. That will deal way over 100 damage if you've got nothing on your party there. That will kill you. Okay, let's see. I think I want to full heal myself. You gotta kill Fu Yang first, because I think he can... I forget what he can do. He can do something. Okay, phew. We're okay then. I forget, maybe... I don't know if he heals or revives or something? I forget. But anyway. Yeah, that feather attack blocks all your physical attacks. You want to get oomph on my two fighters with the... on my two fighters with the miracle swords, so that way they'll practically be able to heal themselves. Now, you see how Chaumain used that charging attack, or whatever it is. When he does that, you want Solo to defend, because he's going to probably take the brunt of his attack. He'll probably use, like, a kick on all your party members. Usually he'll do that to follow it up. Not always, but usually. Yeah, you see, that would have dealt well over 200 damage to Solo, and he could have died. So, attack there. Yeah, I think we can afford to defend now, and yeah, let's just use the Sage's Stone. Now, you noticed I've given everyone one of those, Lucida shards that I bought way earlier in the game. What that does is if you use it as an item in battle, it'll cure the fuddle status, which Fu Young can inflict on your party there. So let's have Borya defend there, and let's see. Yeah, just full heal there. Oh. Game? I was trying to use full heal preemptively because I figured he was going to do that, but apparently, the one time I want them to go first, it doesn't work. So, yeah, now we gotta use that Yggdrasil dude. Get Insulate going up again. I'm getting a little lucky here. Usually they're just so fast, I can't get my healing in before they kill someone, so. Nuts. Let's see, let's get Oomph going back up on Ragnar there, and keep on going with that Sage's Stone. Oh, I love the Sage's Stone. Ow! Alright, got one of them. That's the hard part. Once you get one of them down, the Chaumain's relatively easy there. Let's bring in Kirill there, because Chaumain only uses physical attack, so if I can survive, and... wait a minute. You know, I think I want Solo to, I want Solo to full heal on Ragnar there. Then we'll get Sap on him. And if you get double cab off on everyone, you won't be immune to his physical attacks, but you'll pretty much be able to survive anything he throws at you. Sometimes he'll get like a critical hit and he'll just kill you. But if you're able to get double cab off going, you should be fine. Yeah, you see, that didn't even deal, like, 200 damage, which it can sometimes. Wow. He's got... I am making this look a lot easier than it actually is. You know, I might be able to... No, let's just keep going. I was thinking of maybe bringing in Maya yet, but, no, let's hold off on that for now. Yeah, we can deal 300 damage. Look at that. So let's bring in Maya now, because we've got Oomph going on everyone. And, yeah, let's go with Kefrizzle there. Or, you know, if we bring in Meena, then we can go, or I can have her. Yeah, I don't need to use Sap. I can have her just use the Sage Stone. There we go. Wow. Yeah, I am just so lucky in this battle here today. They've got, like, over 2,500 HP. They've got a lot. So, and they just takes a while to kill them. Yeah, just keep on going all out at this point. I think we're in the clear now. We don't need Insulate anymore. Fu Young can also use a Disruptive Wave to remove your buffs, but he never got around to it, so we got a little lucky there. Yeah, Oomph is just so good with the Miracle Swords, because, I mean, look, I don't even have to heal Solo and Ragnar hardly in the battle. Ow! I don't think Kabuff helps with that. But, whatever. Maybe I should bring in Borya again to reestablish Oomph. Now I'll think about it. Yeah, when he gets ready for an attack, that'll reduce all damage you deal to him to 10%. Yeah. Oh, wow. But I think we should almost have him at this point. Yeah, just sit on your ass and do nothing. Thanks. Woohoo! Got him. We better get a damn good reward for this. Yeah, that's one thing I love about the post-game content. They have bosses that are remotely challenging. Sometimes they just, like, a lot of games when they add post-game content, they just throw stuff on top of it just to, well, put something there to give you a silly reason to buy the new game or something. It's no challenge at all. Here, they got awesome equipment, kick-ass boss fights with that are harder than even the final boss of the game. That's how you do post-game content. What's that? Maybe I should make some scrambled eggs for you guys. Nah. What the? Yeah, let's get out of here. Just walk up there. Oh. Well, okay, I guess we can go down there. Ride the wind, babe. Just let the volcano get you out of here. I don't know how that even works, but, okay, there we go. But where is the Yggdrasil flower? What does it do? Find out next time on Let's Play Dragon Quest IV! This is H.C. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!